Today is a day for when men and women of distinguished identities, like all of you, gather to celebrate, thank God, and make men. It must be a great occasion. Back then, the greatest achievement of any young man was the occasion of marriage. Omyaka jeyira, amyaka yanje kwa wo inomkazo kazara na barongo uko buri wa man. But I must assure you that currently, today the world has changed. The greatness of a youthful man begins to be felt when they don an attire like what my colleagues and I are donning today. Fellow graduates, the preeminent people in my life are Mr. Kawashang Sebastian and his wife, the chief guest of honor, Mr. Fajir Mande, a very passionate educationist, enthusiastic, principled, and humble man. Other family members, distinguished guests, spouses and friends, ladies and gentlemen, I salute you all in your respective capacities in the name of love, unity, and democracy. Today, I recount on a worthwhile academic journey that I have moved this far. As a little boy, for circumstances around my birth and nature were at that time telling how limited opportunities dream to be somebody were at that time. At a tender age, when a young Ivan, now a big man, couldn't understand the meaning of a word, a school or classroom, he was led by his father, then and mother, with small provisions of local food, to go and start the journey, shrouded in mists of uncertainty. The journey began in 2005. For now more than 15 years, God and God alone has protected, defended, and guided my journey. I give glory and honor to the Almighty God who has seen through right from the time I started this journey of academics till now when I have accomplished my bachelor's degree. For his providence, grace, and protection, this has been possible. The first interaction with school for a rural, less privileged man whose dialect comprised of only Nyankore Chiga, the introduction of a new language was a very key point of excitement and adventure. The alphabet of English language, the vowels A, E, I, O, U, and their subsequent translation to into our mother dialect, A, E, O, U, made education not only interesting, but also something very near to my young mind. I can remember, even after more than 15 years, the musical songs and the teacher's voice stressed in song teaching us the vowel song. We used to sing this song. So now, as I speak, I fully qualify of all these beautiful ladies here. Whether engaged or not, I think I have a stand to now propose and say something. So now that I have attained a certain level of education, I thank God for that. You can still see how, even today, more than 15 years from that time, when that song was blasted to the young mind of Ivan, the sacred and internal beauty of my first English language musical piece. In that song, there is the word certificate, it is in English. And then it was heard by then. Though it was complicated in pronunciation, it still had the beauty to touch my soul and make an imprint on my mind for now 15 years. The journey that took shape in the end of the first decade of 2000, when I completed my primary school, was filled with experiences that I had gathered, and they became ingrained in the deep thoughts in my heart and in my mind. These experiences became a deep, thoughtful road that would keep on telling me, like a voice, that I had to go to secondary school and let alone to university, which I did in 2018. The expectations that my little mind had envisaged from songs. The song we had, we also had another song, which used to go like this. Ola kola chiwe, ola kola chiwe, ola kola chiwe, kolmare bishop. Java doctor, java doctor, java doctor, kolmare bishop. So we used to have such songs. Then, those songs peeped into future jobs of doctors, engineers, lawyers, that formed the keep of thought that promoted my enthusiasm to read harder. The deep experiences that I gathered during the course of academic journey became the hallmark of my plans throughout the rest of my education journey. In secondary school, when I joined Secretary Mshanga, there came a time when all dreams, a great educated future, became a realist that I came to the classroom with the gusto that I intended to keep pushing my heart to love secondary school, to love the journey that would lead to the far-fetched dream of land of an educated future. When I came to secondary school in about senior two, I realized that I needed to go for a recognizable personality. When we are in schools normally, I never wanted to be under ladies and gentlemen. I always wanted to be an outstanding gentleman among all other students, the same way I'm planning to be outstanding among the 1,000 students and plus, which we have graduated yesterday. I beg with due respect to welcome the senior PRO of my great institution, Mr. Trinomuzin Robin. Thank you so much for honoring my invitation. The biblical verse, "A great name is to be chased more than riches and treasures," it became a superimposing ideology and person maxim, which saw me realize my brain's capacity and need to be a speaker and a leader. That was the time I realized that students who stood out then were always talented in music, dance, and drama, sports like football, volleyball, and among others. But here, a poor Ivan was talented in none. Son of a farmer, suffered. I wanted to stand out, but unfortunately, I never even had any sense of style or fashion. Didn't know how to dribble even a ball. Couldn't even pull out a single stroke, as you have evidenced here. I was just faking, trying to please, but my dancing strokes are not well. So then I suffered. People who had that talent enjoyed themselves. Girls in school liked boys who could dance very well, who were very good footballers, or who had swag in dressing. And above all, they wanted someone who was bright that he could be consulted in mathematics, physics, or chemistry. I was not a very bright student. I could not be the last, I couldn't be the first. I was always there. I could not be chopped, but they could not read me on assembly as a person who has outstood in academics. I would end up, I was not even bright in class. That meant that if I didn't work on my personality, I would end up the whole of my life or secondary school without getting even a mere girl to be my friend, because I had no things that they liked. That's how I entered leadership. since girls liked rubbing shoulders with leaders. And actually my plan produced fruits that even brought girls not only in secondary school, but the magical plan made me a prince charming that you can even see these beautiful ladies who are my friends as evidence. When I stood for good president, these ones, at least each day, they would want to take a selfie with me because I was standing for a very good post to lead a premier-minded institution. So I found my luck in leadership and public speaking. And in any case, when you are a public speaker, when you are a debater, you have the capacity to lead the students, because what identifies us as human beings is not what we dress, is not what we eat, where we hang out from, but what we speak. However much you may be smart, you may be rich, but the moment you open your mouth, that's when people will determine who is so and so. So the moment I could be given a platform, really, I could attract the girls who are yearning for, footballers who are yearning for, fashionists. At least even me there, I could be their king, the same way you see them here. They know that if anything is related to speaking, I am the solution. The greatest myriads of experiences that I have gathered throughout my journey have come with my advancement to the university. The student leadership into which destiny that had come to me in my secondary school years back resurfaced in my university. In my university times, the destiny pushed me to realize that I had to be a leader once more. So I had to dare life a little more further. These people, Price, you have seen her. She was very vibrant. Prosy, Martin, Priscilla, and other people were not here, became my moving engine as far as my political ambitions were concerned. They gave me comfort. They supported me in any way to make me a better student, a better leader, and a better academician. The thought that the degree alone, without any leadership or social contract, would not be sufficient for the day became a thing and a cherished ideal that pushed me for greater thoughts and led to greater heights. I pursued my dreams, and throughout that journey, I encountered the hardship of deep stress and time of thoughts that came to be of realizing that I had to be a great person at campus, that I would be a famous and renowned individual. I never wanted to be in Kyambogo as an everyday man. Even at UBC, they know. Even in Kororo, where I intern, even among my friends, I no longer want to be considered as an everyday man. You look at him as an option. I must put everything possible to make sure that you have the reason to say I should be with Ivan. So when you see all these students, they were very bright and what they are not giving, they are not sugarcoating me. For me, not until I give you a reason to keep around me, I can't stop hustling. And I can proudly tell you, after the electoral process, my lecturers, classmates, they all started calling me a new name, Great President, and from that day, doors were open. Now these people, some called me Great President, others called me by my brand, which I used, Obateman. Trust me, when you enter Kyambogo, even if you find there new students now, and you talk of Obateman, they know it. So that was the brand we had given ourselves. So I started enjoying those benefits. Me just contesting, I could storm offices. How I came to know this man, it was because of that. Having the capacity, having the humility to stand and lead about 3,500 students in an institution, just having that thought and continuing to execute that thought was a powerful decision I never regret. If someone here knows about Katunda village in Mitoma district, where my heritage can be traced, they must know that for someone from such a place to declare intention and show capacity to lead such a great institution is a big dream. Nobody ever thought about a person from Mitoma hailing from Katunda, a deep village, a son of a farmer, Stakawasha, is a farmer that would come have that vision and that passion to contest. But I'm glad to tell you that we lived our dream. The lessons from the campaign live within me till today. I'm very grateful that I even opened my eyes to desire to influence on a much bigger platform. While I searched for that platform, UBC, the national broadcaster, came through, and the amount of influence that the great broadcaster has had on my personal and professional growth is remarkable. If you can look at the very beautiful ladies, the wise and outstanding gentlemen here representing UBC, you can understand what I'm talking about. Immediately after I lost the again presidential race, went into COVID-19. From there, I hatched a plan that I am not in position to influence students through the leadership that is provided by the university as per student constitution. I must look for a brand B where I can influence people positively. And UBC became my second home. I met these enthusiastic and humble down-to-earth ladies that did not see me as a junior, as a person who had no experience, but they embraced me and tried their best to teach me what I could do to become the best of myself. Yesterday, I graduated with a bachelor's degree of arts with education, literature, English. But on the other hand, I leave Kyambogo, the institution which is always represented by the PRO. 3 months back, I was in Kenya trying to, if you are careful in my citation, I'm trying to document causes of poverty in developing countries, not in Uganda. So I was in Nairobi, I met a professor. We are just off interview, having a simple discussion. So in so doing, he tried to ask where a young man studied from, not studying from, because he thought I had finished by the virtue of the exposure I gave myself. But when I talked about Kyambogo University, he told me it is a recognizable university, Kyambogo and Makerere University, other universities in Uganda. I'm not saying they are bad, but I'm quoting what he told me, that Kyambogo is a best university for the course I was pursuing. So I'm proud that I studied from Kyambogo. So I did not, on the other hand, I didn't leave the Maita University as a mere literature and English teacher. I leave this institution as a junior journalist with national broadcaster, UBC. I leave this institution a better human being in all aspects. I leave this institution a more passionate and patriotic Ugandan. And while I leave this institution, forget the limiting circumstances around my birth and growth. Today, I'm a dreamer, I'm a believer, and most importantly, I'm an achiever. Ladies and gentlemen, today while I transition into a professional world, I'm greatly indebted for the spirit rendered to me by Kololo SS that allowed me in turn with them while I pursued my journalistic passion with UBC. And UBC for providing a platform, a naive and inexperienced, passionate young man that has by far jump-started by journalism career. In the same spirit, Mr. Sylvia Pierre of Kyambogo University, I appreciate it for accepting me with my big ambitions that often rendered me inconsistent and unserious. I'm forever grateful for those institutions. Most importantly, Kyambogo University accommodated a journalist, a politician, and a teacher to be among students. Maybe we are pursuing a one professional dream. I'm ever indebted for that. I want to encourage my fellow graduates to use the same spirit you have shown, the sacrifices you have made, the chikomando you have eaten. You can't go to campus and tell me you finish without eating chikomando, given the fact that majority of us, 90%, come from average families. So that chikomando you have eaten, The sleepless nights you have endured, this I promise, you colleagues, is our ticket to our next destination. Today, to my elders here and those following us online, plus my fellow comrades and colleagues from different institutions I'm working and identifying with, I call upon you to speak our names in rooms full of opportunities. We have been approved and certified by Kyambogo University that we are competent and skilled enough to do any work in our field and other related fields. I'm proud to say that today, my dear comrades, I have grown and we are different from the people we have been. Now we are degree holders. We are no longer called Senior 6 dropouts or Senior 6 leavers. We are now degree holders. Now I can comfortably. What prides me most is that during my first intermediate degree, I managed to expose myself to people even who have PhDs and who have big qualifications. Take a case in point. During my journalism career, I have interviewed a former chairman in a passionate educationist, education consultant, a very principled, humble gentleman, Mr. Fajir Mande. I have encountered with a senior PRO of Kyambogo University. I have interviewed vice chancellor and his deputy. I have interviewed a number of big academic names. So I believe by getting a degree, it has simplified and given me a platform to explore greater heights. Allow me appreciate Mr. Fajir Mande for reaffirming what makes you a generational icon. Your faith in young people, your motivation, your humility and knowledge amaze me always as a person. Ladies and gentlemen, I continue to thank everyone for honoring an invitation of a then less privileged gentleman from Katunda, a son of a peasant, who at one time never thought that he could make things possible. I have learned one important lesson in life, which has pushed me all this far, that no matter how educated you are, no matter how rich you are, the moment you don't have a gift of discipline, then you are a danger to the society. I implore you, my dear fellow graduates, my elders, my senior colleagues at UBC, my elders at Kyambogo, my elders from Hillside, and all of you, my in-laws and friends, that let us remain humble and disciplined if we want to achieve in life. Lastly, and most profoundly, my parents, Mr. Sebastian Kobasha, and your wife, Madam Yosavita Ramzia, remain the unsung heroes behind all the success I have achieved. And now is the time when the tremendous effort and sacrifice they did becomes prominent and vividly able to be immortalized in glorious celebration. As my parents, you have guided and corrected me whenever there was need. As my elders, you have shaped my life and aligned my reason to work towards being a better individual. Thank you so much, and may the Almighty God bless you with more life and riches. Lastly, but not the least, there is something which has been technically and deliberately left out of my citation, which was said by Madame Lolini Kazimoto. Next time, I want to address you as the CEO of my own company. Thank you so much, ladies and gentlemen, for your kind attention. I remain Ivan Tukundane, graduate specialist of English and literature from Kyambogo University in the year 2018. I thank you.
Amazing. I'ma show you the love that you've been missing, baby. What you've been missing, honey. Prison. Girl, the love I got for you, that's in a prison. That's in a prison, baby. Baby, me jack all up, but you know, baby. We can make a little baby. Oh, money, put your pocket. You want to call your nickel, jump pocket. Baby, me jack out of Kobasin will love you. We can make a little baby, you money could jump pocketsy. You want to come, money could jump pocketsy. You want to come,
I'm no proud, baby. Is it cause I'm home?
Now they make you the father for me.
Now they make you the father
for me.
I'm no proud,
I'm no proud.
Is it cause I'm home?
Now they make you the father for me.
Now they make you the father
for me.
Baby, I'm begging. Say this your love, go take me to heaven. Anything that talk, baby, say no devil. Man, no give a stop on this, see your level.
Nah, nah, nah.
Money, baby, I'm begging. Say this your love, go take me to heaven. Man, no give a stop on this, see your level.
Fajil Musa Mande is a renowned educationist and performing artist. His profile is much more bigger. The pages are very many. We need a PDF profile and perhaps share with you to go and read more about him. But he is the gentleman before us. I guess the experience you've had and where has gone, you might double all the experience of many of us here. So allow me at this juncture invite you to clap for our chief guest. But like I said in the beginning, I'm not in the best shoes to invite him to speak to us. How about if the senior public relations officer came on the podium to invite for us the chief guest to address the people herein? I thank you so much.
Thank you very much, the Director of Ceremonies. I am Ruben Tinomjuni indeed, as I have been introduced. And I serve at Kyambogo, as they told you. I am here to attend this celebration. One time, I was seated in my office normally, on a normal day, and someone entered and said he was a journalist with UBC. And he wanted to make a documentary about something. And as the PRO, my principal responsibility is to protect the integrity of the university at all costs and at all times. Even when you call me at 3 a.m., I will pick your phone if you are asking about Kyambogo, and I will respond. If it's about me, I'll say, I'm sleeping. But if it's Kyambogo, I will respond. So he came, I said, give me the questions. The questions were funny. And me, as a face of the university, I couldn't respond. I said, no, these questions, I used the word, are biased. I said, and that time we were in the not-so-good political season of Tunduru and we got to press. Yeah, yes. We were in those days of Tunduru. Tunduru was a president subscribing to NUP, and even his successor was the same. And so we were very careful on how we handle matters. And what I saw was bending towards the Tunduruism. And so I engaged him. And one thing that really attracted me to him, he's humble. One thing that I enjoyed about him, he's willing to be corrected. One thing that endeared me to him, he wants to work with you for the good of what he's working on. And to me, that was enough. So we said, let's work on the questions. And then he was bending towards the sports policy, which didn't have much. We changed it, and we changed literally everything, and redirected his script for the documentary. And he did it very well, and he kept very in touch with me and shared with me the final product. And that's why I came today. I have been MC of the graduation since Wednesday, yesterday, and today. And of course, before the graduation begins, we are extremely tired and busy, and rarely do I attend such things. I just go home to chill. But I said, I will come. And even the event... Yeah, even the event started when I was still... he said we are... He read for me on the program where I had reached. I said, we are still in the event. But when finally I am done, I will come. And I came and spent a long time here in the jam. I chose to park somewhere and walk so that I am here. And I am here to honor you, Ivan, to show that your character is respected and appreciated. And that's why I am here as one of your people. And I know you know him. You know other parts of him. So that's why I'm here. And I'm glad I'm here. The only, really, in these graduations, we are saying congratulations. We say congratulations to you and to you who have come to show solidarity with him. We are here to congratulate all of you and to urge you that this is, you haven't arrived. You have actually started. This is a foundation. You have laid the foundation. If we all want to be like him, I am not even a quarter of him, really. No, I'm just beginning also. If we all want to be like him, or at least somewhere, because we may not be like him, there are people that God chose and chooses, and he directs their path. But then there are others that God directs in different ways. So if we want to be like him, this is the foundation. Keep on keeping on, and whatever you want to do, do it very well. And the world will identify who you are. So I am here, one, to congratulate you. But the second responsibility they gave me, the Master of Ceremony, I want to know what you studied also. What you studied or what you are studying?
I did a bachelor's degree in journalism and mass communication.
No wonder. Yeah. I knew we were there. I felt you are turning towards there. Yeah, so another responsibility you gave me is to welcome this polished, accomplished, complete man. You have said what you have said. I can't add more. Sir, you're welcome.
I am very, very happy to be here. Very, very, very happy to be here. First of all, I'd like to inform you that earlier today, I was at Hotel Africana, and I was meeting or making a presentation to former members of parliament, who were supposed to be about 200. And I was making a presentation to review retirement and what it means. That's where I came from, to come here. But the most important message I passed on to these honorable members of parliament, retirees, fellow Ugandans, men and women, was that life success depends on how much multi-skilled you are. It is very dangerous to be mono-skilled, and remember it. Mono-skill, like the saying says in Luganda, that when you take only one route all the time, you will be trapped and you will die. And you've seen how people have been trapped, particularly during the COVID time and so on, because they knew only one thing and didn't even know it very well. But it's enough to only know one thing. It's nearly a crime. For me, I think it's a sin, and a sin for which some of us might go to hell. Because God will say, I gave you all the abilities. That's why I told you to go out there and take control. And I've been challenging religious people, priests and all this, that God packed you. He can't have told you to go and take control when he has not packaged you with the necessary thing. But does Christianity, does religion unpack us? Actually, most of the time, religion packs us like beggars, not people with a lot of talents and a lot of skills and all this. So I was telling them, multi-skilling is very, very important. If you retire in life, and all of you are going to retire, okay, or they are in retirement, if you know very little skills, you are more or less dead before you die, finally. Okay? Now, I want to appreciate here that what has been said now amounts to multi-skilling. When the biography of Ivan was read, it's multi-skilling. When we talk about Kyambogo, it's multi-skilling. When we talk about even when the father stood up to speak, he was talking about multi-skilling. Are you getting me? So multi-skilling is very, very important. And I want to take note and accept now also to join you, people, to join you, Ivan, okay? First of all, to congratulate you, all right, on graduation, plus you, members, other friends, on graduating. But I want to emphasize that graduation actually virtually means nothing. It's what you have carried and what you are willing to carry that matters. Are you getting me? And I think it has been mentioned here, okay? Muzei, father, daddy mentioned it, and I like this. Muzei agambire nti akaba ine inkoni ikumi chonka ya kwatahemu ya mtu arumu ishomero, that he picked one of the inkoni and used it to send the child to school. He has completed that school. Hati ya komendi ya graduation nandiki ogomkoro. This is another inkoni, which means that this is now a rostrum for you to take off to another level. Completely. It's not complete at all. It's like you are beginning off now. You've been equipped with the skills to begin off successfully. So I want to note that. I want in that process also to join you in thanking Kyambogo University. Actually, in one of my books I say, my secondary school prepared me, molded me, but Kyambogo Teachers College by that time, NTC, okay, molded me and completed me. Me as Fajr Mande. I remember my days at Kyambogo University. I was rounded up. I was the Uganda House captain, athletics captain. I was a minister of refectory. I was a chairman of the drama club. I was in the ballroom club. I was in the college band playing the rhythm guitar. I started the cross-country running from Kyambogo to Bahai, Kamocha, where. I was also, I was also taking literature and English, and I was the first student ever of the seven, we were seven only students, to take physical education in Uganda. So I am a faster there, and I chose it deliberately because I wanted to take something that would make me unique, because I've always believed I'm not like any other person. I am the only me, and you are the only you. Are you getting me? But most people live copying and imitating other people's lives. So they don't live their own lives. So Kyambogo actually made me find myself and made me define myself and go. It is from Kyambogo that I was selected to go and attend a course in Kenya. Loitokitok, outward bound training school. Where I went there, I was the only student selected. I went and trained for 3 months. Okay, they wanted to retain me to remain there to train. But that course transformed me. It made me on top of what the college had trained me in. It finished me. All right? So Kyambogo for me is a great center. And I can see what it has contributed to Ivan's life. And I'm imagining that Ivan is not in isolation. It must have continued now, although it is at university level. Me, I attended it at grade five. But it has contributed to shaping the human beings of Uganda. It did for me, and this is public, I'll declare it anyway. It completed me, put me into the man I am, the Ugandan I am. The other thing which I would like to thank is UBC. UBC really, for me, has been one. I've been following the mass media houses in Uganda, and I'm one person who says that the mass media in Uganda is the biggest school we have in this country. And if it wanted to kill Uganda, it would kill Uganda. If it wanted to make Uganda grow, it will make Uganda grow. It's much bigger than the school system. It's much bigger than the home school. But UBC has done a lot of work. UBC contributed to training me. I remember I was the first person to introduce youth programs on UBC when it was still UTV. And we ran those programs for 3 years, UTV, I was running them. UTV has trained a lot of people who I know have been shaped by UBC. UBC, I know people, okay? And I'm not ashamed to mention them. I was trying to remember one person who I saw when I was RDC of Tororo. And this person used to interview me a lot, Hashaka Mbaza, the current RDC, Kapchura, Swam district. That is a young man I saw. He used to interview me on radio, Star Radio, and I knew this fellow would become a great fellow. He's now an RDC. Recently, I was trying to get in touch with him. I failed somehow. I think his phone had something wrong. But I wanted to get in touch with this young man I saw growing up while he worked with the UBC and who is now a greater person. Because to be an RDC by all positions, yes, is a great opportunity for you to grow into a bigger person and grow a bigger person. All right? One time I was seated at home with my wife and I was watching him. Okay? What is his name? Yes, Wedulo. Every time Mark Wedulo appears on television, I say that young man has got a great future. Because I see quality in him, I see determination in him, I see an all-rounded approach in him, not just a gambler, mass media worker. Are you getting me? He is going to be a great person. And I don't want to say, even when I watch you, okay? When I watch Owana is one great person who I have seen growing out of UBC. There have been many others, but in short, I want to thank Uganda Broadcasting Corporation, one, for contributing to my growth, because I started doing radio and television with UBC TV, UTV by that time, and radio, And that was back in 1973. I've been on the radio and television since 1973. And I'm one civil servant in Uganda who has been most on television and radios in Uganda, apart from newspapers. So UBC, congratulations for shaping not only Ivan, but for shaping all these great people here. All right? I would like to thank you very much for that. Let me come to the other point, which is, again, a unique thing. I must tell you, I'm 74 years old. This is the smallest graduation party I've attended in terms of number. And I was thinking, the moment I entered here, I said, fine. Is it a question that people have let down Ivan? Is it a deliberate? But my conclusion by the time I stood up there was that Ivan planned to have a small number of people. Opposite to majority of Ugandans. Personally, I'm very fed up with huge crowds, huge crowds. You have a graduation party, you invite nearly everybody. It's like we are showcasing. Are you getting me? Even funerals, you find people who would not even asking who has died, you know, attending funerals. Are you getting me? All right? So for me, this crowdism, the crowd mentality. I want to thank you for not being a crowd mentality. Because I'm sure, Ivan, I was not here with you. You definitely invited the people to be here, those who you wanted to be here. And you had your reason. And the reason is you have a common thinking with the people who are attending here. And I see everybody who has talked, including your dad and your mother, all of them are practical, multi-skilled people. So you are unique, you are not a commoner, you are not a generalist. I would like to clap for him again. Okay? I want to thank you, ladies and gentlemen, and you members here, that this is only the beginning. Our job is to increase our skills. The more skills you have, you heard about my biography, I mean my CV, but one of the ways why I am what I am, the name I've built and so on and so forth, is because I packed myself with a lot of skills. A lot of skills. And I've always believed the more you do and you know how to do, the greater you will be. And each one of you can be greater now if you learn to do more things and do more things and do more things. I've never seen anybody running mad because they are doing very many things. No. The people who run mad are those who are poor in thinking and they don't know anything else. Have you ever seen a person becoming mad because they know how to do many things? The richer they were, no matter what the circumstances. Right? I would like to encourage you, let's continue this spirit of multi-scaling. Let us do as many things as possible and on principle, including character, as Ivan has said. We must protect our character. I told the people today that I retired when I was 53 years. And my name was up there. Children used to study about me as a commissioner. Not because anybody directed them, but I had worked for the name. I had worked for the job and done the job. Are you getting me? And it was because of my ability to do the work. Each one of us, we can change Uganda. We can change Africa. And it is only you and our children, and our grandchildren, when we bring them up properly, that they will transform Uganda. Ladies and gentlemen, we are falling down in many areas as a country. Discipline is becoming worse. Corruption is increasing. Are you getting me? Laziness is increasing. Copying is increasing. Womanizing is increasing. Small children sleeping with men and becoming pregnant is increasing. Are you getting me? We need to change and change that trend. But it's you and me with these multi-skills that can change our country. And I'm sure God will support us to do that. All right? Lastly, I thought of a gift to give to Ivan. I wrapped it like all gifts, but now I think I'm going to open it. Sorry, Ivan, I'm going to open your gift. I'm going to remove this paper because I have gifted Ivan with a book, one of my books. one of my books. Okay? And this book is my first book, which I wrote a book and published in 2008. Right? Yeah. I think it's about the wrapper anymore. What is inside is what matters. Okay? This is a book, Ivan, which I am giving you, gifting you, and congratulating you. The book is called Self-Engineering, A True Story About Success by Fajr Mani. Self-Engineering. Self-Engineering. Okay? Ivan, you've been talking about how you have started forming yourself. You are actually engineering. And I'm telling you, ladies and gentlemen, you and me, we are responsible for engineering ourselves. Putting ourselves together, building ourselves, turning things around in a better way, and keeping our discipline. This is only my story, how I engineered myself, and how I've come to be what I am. And I thought on this day, when you are graduating, and when you have shown already signs that you are building yourself, I would give you this book to use it, and you engineer yourself to greater and greater and greater. Baba Ivan, mtabano wa wena mhereze kitabu. Aye yombeke. Agende, agende, agende. Nano wanda dambe, chankasi zaku, kakazaro mwana, no mwana kamutenda ka, yafura, yafoka omombeke. Kandi yafoka omundu, aliyo mkisane, charuhanga. Are you listening? Because I believe you are in the picture of God. Are you listening? I am in the image of God. Ivan, I want you to work on the image of being a God. Are you getting me? You cannot be equal to God, but you are a son of God. You can be like God. Not exactly like God. Are you getting me? So he was there telling. And the more we are like God, the more we'll go to heaven. May God bless you everyone.
Thank you so much for the wonderful remarks, Mr. Fajr Mande. We shall need you to tell us how we can get a copy of that book, where we can find it. There are many readers here who would really want to tap into that piece of knowledge that you've shared with the world. Mr. Jimmy Aluri, kindly a prayer. We go for...
Thank you very much, MC. My work is simple, to pray for the food. So let's pray. Father, I want to thank you for this wonderful moment. Thank you for bringing us together once more. And Lord, as we partake of what Ivan and the family has given unto us, may it nourish our spirit, may it strengthen us, and may we be blessed, and may you bless them and multiply whatever they've gotten from as they bless our spirits, our souls, and our stomachs. We thank you, we bless you. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray and believe. Amen.
I thank the Almighty God, my family, lecturers, mentors, and friends for making my dream a reality. I'm Ivan Tukundane. God bless you all.